Now see one more example on the method of undetermined coefficients. See here, the problem is that solve this equation d2y by dx2 minus 2dy by dx plus 2y is equal to x plus e to the power x. See here we have two functions and on the right hand side of equality sign, this x and e to the power x with a plus sign they are attached. So we can use our earlier methods also for solving this problem. See here, the auxiliary equation will be m square minus 2m plus 2 equal to 0. So m will be 2 plus minus root 4 minus 8 by 2. This is equal to 2 plus minus 2i by 2. So its value is 1 plus minus I. So here the root is alpha plus I beta and alpha minus I beta type. Alpha is 1 and beta is 1. So the complementary function will be c1 e to the power 1 into x and within bracket a cos 1x plus b sine 1x. Use this formula. And after this, you need to find out the particular integral. So the particular integral can be used. You can evaluate it by using our earlier methods. When this is two functions, so first evaluate particular integral for this function x, and second evaluate particular integral for this function e to the power x. And then add both of them. So it will be your particular integral for this equation. And we have evaluated complementary function. So the general solution will be y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So in this way, you can solve this problem, no difficulty. Now we proceed on to our further next topic, which is homogeneous linear equations or Cauchy-Euler equations. See, what does this mean? A differential equation of this form, x to the power n dn by dxn plus p1 into x to the power n minus 1 dn minus 1 by dxn minus 1 plus 1 plus pn minus 1 into x divided by dx plus pn y is equal to capital X. See here, this p1, p2, pn, all of them are constants. And here, the nth order differential coefficient. And here, the x power of x is n. Here, n minus 1th order differential coefficient and power of x is n minus 1 and so on. So this type of differential equation is known as Cauchy-Euler equation or homogeneous linear equations. So it can be solved by assuming x is equal to e to the power z. We assume here that x is equal to e to the power z. Take logarithm of both sides. So it will be z is equal to log x. And now differentiate this with respect to x. So it will be dz by dx is equal to 1 by x. So this is our. Now we will write d by dz for d. See here, we will evaluate dy by dx, d2y by dx, and so on. See here, dy by dx can be written as dy by dz into dz by dx. This is equal to 1 by x into dy by dz. Why? Because dz by dx is 1 by x. So it is 1 by x, capital dy. This capital D stands for d by dz. So this capital dy is x. This d2y by dx2 is equal to d by dx, this is equal to d by dx, 1 by x, dy by dz. So there are two functions, 1 by x and dy by dz. So it can be equal to 1 by x, d2y by dz2, dz by dx minus dz by dy by dz into 1 by x square. Again, after this is equal to 1 by x square d2y by dz2 minus 1 by x square divided by dz. So this is equal to 1 by x square d2y minus dy. So this is equal to 1 upon x square d minus 1y. This is equal to x square d2y by dx square is equal to capital D minus 1y. So means this is equivalent to this. We will write this one for this one. Similarly, we can evaluate x cube d3y by dx2 is capital D minus 1 d minus 2y and so on. Now see our example based on this one. Solve x2, x square, d2 y by dx2 minus 3x divided by dx plus 4y is equal to x square. This equation, this problem was asked in your university 2004. See here, this is an equation of Cauchy-Euler type, and it is homogeneous linear differential equation. So here we will substitute x is equal to e to the power z. See here, it should be z, not x. So this z can be equal to log x. Now differentiate this with respect to x. So it will be dz by dx will be 1 by x. So we will write here capital D equivalent to d by dz. So the given problem can be written as capital D d minus 1 minus 3 capital D plus 4 y is equal to 2 into e to the power z. Because x is your e to the power z, so x square will be e to the power 2z. It implies that d2 minus d minus 3d means minus 4d plus 4 y is equal to 2 into e to the power 2z. Or d minus 2 whole square y is equal to 2 into e to the power 2z. So the auxiliary equation is m minus 2 whole square is equal to 0. It means m is 2 and 2. So the complementary function will be c1 plus c2z e to the power 2z. Now here it is not x. It should be z. Because here we have capital D and capital D is d by dz. So the particular integral will be 1 by d minus 2 whole square 2 e to the power 2z here. So it can be written as 2 e to the power 2z into 1 by, since it is e to the power 2, so d will be replaced by d plus 2. So d plus 2 minus 2 whole square over 1. So this is equal to 2 into e to the power 2z by 1 into 1 upon d square over 1. So 1 upon d square over 1 means integrate 1 with respect to z twice. So it will be z square by 2. It means the particular integral is z square e to the power 2z. And the general solution of the reduced equation will be y is equal to this complementary function plus particular integral. So it is c1 plus c2z e to the power 2z plus z square e to the power 2z. Now substitute the value of z. What? This is your z is equal to log x. So it is equal to c1 plus c2 log x into x square plus log x whole square into x square. So this is our complete solution. See one more example. Solve x square d2y by dx2 minus x divided by dx plus y is equal to 2 log x. Here also this is a linear differential equation, but it is homogeneous. So it is Cauchy-Euler type. So here for solving this equation, we will substitute x is equal to e to the power z or z is equal to log x. So capital D is written as d by dz. So x dy by dx will be capital dy, x square d2y by dx2 will be dd minus 1y and so on. So substitute the values here in the equation. So the given equation will be capital D minus 1 minus D plus 1 Y is equal to 2Z or D square minus 2D plus 1 Y is equal to 2Z. So this is your D minus 1 whole square Y is equal to 2Z. So the auxiliary equation will be M minus 1 whole square is equal to 0. It means M is your 1, 1. Both roots are equal and real. So the complementary function will be C1 plus C2Z e to the power Z. This is our complementary function. Now, the particular integral will be y is equal to 1 upon d minus 1 whole square 2z. This is equal to 2, 1 minus d to the power minus 2z. This is equal to 2 into 1 plus 2d plus 1 over z. This is equal to 2z plus 4. Why? Because this z and 2 into dz, dz is equal to 1. So it is 2z plus 1 multiplied by 2. So it is 2z plus 4. Hence, the general solution of the reduced equation is y is equal to c1 plus c2z e to the power z plus 2z plus 4. Now this is in the form of z, but we need the solution in the form of x. So substitute the value of z. What is the value? The value of z is log x, because we have taken earlier x is equal to e to the power z. So substitute here z is equal to log x. So the general solution will be y is equal to c1 plus c2 log x into this e to the power z is x plus 2 into z is your log x plus 4. This is our general solution for the given homogeneous linear differential equation. There is a problem for you to practice at your home. See, x square d2y by dx2 minus x dy by dx minus 3y is equal to x square into log x. So again, this is a differential equation, linear differential equation, and it is homogeneous. So it is of type Cauchy-Euler equations. For solving this type of problems, you need to substitute x is equal to e to the power z. And as earlier we have done in our two problems, so you can solve this using the earlier used technique. So if you have any difficulty or any query for the for all your difficulties or problems, you can ask me your questions in the my WhatsApp or on my email, or you can call me. Also, this lecture, this class will be available on YouTube. If any one of you missed this one, go to the YouTube, my YouTube channel, and there you will find this whole lecture. Even if you have any difficulty, there is a comment box. You can write your comments in the comment box, and I will reply them.